The true test is going to be the rapid aging. We're going to find out who brings the best.
Consumers want barrel-aged products out there. And on the legal side and the illegal side, we want to make that buck quick.
All right, guys, coming into this competition, we asked you to bring your own tools and equipment to best rapid age your liquor. We're anxious to see what you brought to the table in order to do that.
I think the legal distillers, they have an edge in this because, you know, they don't want rapid aging these days.
You know, Timmy, at the end of the day, I think these outlaw distillers are going to have the edge because that's what outlaw distillers have been doing for years.
At the end of this challenge, one legal and one outlaw distiller will be going home. This will be the end of the line for two of you. Bring us your best.
All right, your 5 hours starts now.
I'm a legal distiller, so I'm used to taking a corn liquor and putting it into barrels, and I tuck it away for 2, 3, 4, 5 years at a time, right? However, we were tasked in 5 hours. I've got all these jars laid out in front of me. I've got my American, my French, I've got the Japanese, and I've got the mahogany.
It's a beautiful color, but the flavors left behind from mahogany are quite harsh.
I pulled out whatever tricks I had, took my liquor and washed it over my charred wood there. They said rapid age.
No doubt about that. My brother got color over there already and everything.
We got a lot of science.
We got a lot of technology going on here.
This was passed down to me from my grandfather. I used to watch him take fresh white liquor that wasn't 12 hours off the still, going to sell it as 12 or 20-year-old bourbon.
Frank, what are you doing with that battery charge over there?
It's electrolysis on it. It puts a charge through the liquor there, makes it go through the wood real well.
What I'm gonna do is add toasted spirals rather than adding char because I feel like it won't cloud my jar up. For rapid aging, I'm bringing the super small sonic cleaner. It's a jewelry cleaner. All it's doing is a whole lot of agitating with a little bit of effort.
I know I'm gonna want a 10, 15-year-old bourbon, and unfortunately, 5 hours is gonna make it tough. I need to eat my spinach for this one, because 5 hours of shaking out. But I think with the ultrasonic cleaner and some heavy agitation, I might be able to take it home. There we go, now we're playing with fire.
Well, you know, Michaela, she's got her cement mixer going, that's a first, but you know, honestly, I think it's a good idea.
I think my secret weapon this go around is the cement mixer. It's gonna provide gentle agitation. I don't have to worry about the chips degrading or getting a lot of particulate in there. And I think that it'll allow me to age it to the point that I want, to the flavor profile that I want, without worrying as much about over oaking it.
Well, I'm not the one that brought the cement mixer, but I'll catch up, don't you worry.
Yeah, can you imagine what that was like getting on the plane?
Oh, yeah.
What have you got over there?
Well, I got a bunch of French oak staves that have been charred.
I'm gonna be doing two things. First, I'm gonna try to correct my proof because it was so low.
He's cut a hole in that thing.
And the second part will be trying to age the spirit in 5 hours.
Ta-da!
That'd be a new flavored toothpaste, wouldn't it? Bourbon flavor.
Maybe you ought to get on that.
You know, honestly, there's a whole potpourri of things going on here.
Everyone's got all these big machines. And we got caveman, the general contractor, the jeweler.
The humble toothbrush. I don't know what that is, but I'm very into it.
Boys and girls, we're halfway there. 2.5 hours in, 2.5 hours left.
I don't know if they're gonna need 5 hours or not. Hell, most of them brown already.
I can see a lot of over oak liquor in our future, but maybe they know something we don't.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, I ain't got no idea how this is gonna go.
We know the quality of distillers you are. Becomes our job to cut one from each side of this competition, being the legal and the outlaw side. What we judged you all on was your taste first and foremost, clarity, and how close you came to that 95 proof. We're gonna start with Team Legal.
Trent, I noticed you didn't use any electricity or turning things. You just used the wood. Did a great job. The taste and the flavor, I think your blending skills were off the charts. The other criteria was we're asking you to hit 95 proof, and you came really damn close. 92.
Oh, yeah.
Outstanding. Michaela, I came in and I saw this machine in the back. I didn't know what was going on, but I'll tell you what, it absolutely changed the liquor. The distillate that I was tasting was really clean. It stood out. It wasn't covered up or masked. You had a hydrometer. So we're thinking about, she can't miss this, right? You were at 98, so really close. So outstanding jar.
Thank you.
GP, from where you started with your proof, I mean, you did a steep 180. Color was good, wasn't so pleasant on the back end. But your proof was 95.7.
No way.
Nailed it, Doc.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Now let's move on to Team Outlaw. Frank, you operate like Mark and I do. You know, redneck ingenuity. And putting that spark in your wood, that's exactly what that is. Your flavors were complex. They were deep. We gave you a hallmark of 95, and you went to almost 102. But all in all, fine drink.
Thank you, sir.
Curtis.
Yes, sir.
Deep, rich flavor. I mean, you brought it. A good finish start to end. You struggled a little bit with your clarity. There again, the hallmark we set of 95 proof. You fell a little short again. You were at 79 proof, which is just under that threshold. But all in all, fine job. Congratulations.
Kelly, it tastes good, it looks good, it smells good. You're a little bit off on the proof, though.
I got in my own head.
Your proof came out at 99.2. Outstanding job.
Thank you, sir.
Outlaw, Legal kicked your hind end on proofing. So it goes to show that legal side can work without instruments. So kudos, guys. You know, we tasted a lot of great liquor today, and as an added challenge, we asked you to bring us a jar at 95 proof. In our world, you know, at the end of the day, flavor is what brings customers back for the next jar. So we had to use flavor as the top indicator for the jar that we chose. And I tell you, it was a very, very tough decision.
Unfortunately, it involved the task that one has to go away from each side. But unfortunately, GP, Curtis, y'all didn't make the cut, and we're gonna have to ask you to step out.
Gentlemen, thank you so much.
It's been an honor and a privilege to judge both of you all again.
I came in here wanting to do my absolute best, and the competition has been incredibly stiff. And so I walk amongst giants, and I'm so honored to be here.
We'll do this again.
Oh yeah, definitely. I just feel a whirlwind of emotions. I'm upset because I didn't win, but met a lot of great people. I learned a ton of stuff in a couple of days. Unfortunately, it just wasn't my day. It wasn't my day to shine.
An honor.
Thank you.
The honor's been all ours.
Thank you.
I promise you.
Thank you.